warrior, soldier, man at arms, get down. Scars on my hands and arms, hit town. Nigga know that man is on. Lacerda file comments after file 1, part 5. I wrote this for the description of part 5, but YouTube rejected it because it was too long, and so I decided to record it because it's too important to discard. I have some ideas to share with you for the sake of discussion and mind stimulation. Consider these ideas. In part 5, we learn that there were 7 attempts by the Elohim to develop an advanced human on Earth. But the Saurians did not like the outside influence and genetic manipulation, and that's why there is so much hostility by Lacerta in the beginning. And she was offending the young Swedes by making attacks on Earth scientists. I understand how she feels. Their species took 65 million years to develop, and they have earned their place in this world and on this planet. But in just 50,000 years or so, we are converted by outsiders, invaders, from tree dwellers to rocket scientists. And we have no culture, no history, and no respect for the Saurians, and no knowledge of their history. In addition, our minds have been poisoned against them, making it difficult to establish a harmony with us as neighbors. We don't respect them because they're reptiles, and all we know about reptiles is that they are snakes and crocodiles, and they are far behind us in their development. Now we meet reptiles who are far advanced of us, and have not just sent a man to the moon, but far beyond, and have set up 7 colonies in this solar system. It's time to learn the truth about their existence and respect their life form. Ally with them if at all possible, and be a partner in the husbandry of this planet. We've heard Lacerda's side of this, and this might be what she was taught. There are others in her group to consult, and then we must consult with the other side, the Elohim, to get their side of the story. Whenever I get all my information from just one source, I feel that I've heard the plaintiff speak, but there are more witnesses on both sides, and I did not hear from the defendant yet. And it's too early to put down the gavel and decide the case. How about you? This interview was made by the Swedes in 1999, and Lacerda says that there were 14 species of aliens on this planet at that time, and 3 of them are hostile, including the one that works with our government. Maybe they are the ones who want a drastic reduction in the population here. Are our leaders under their mind control? One of the species on this planet is very far advanced and is no threat to us, but would they help us if they see wrong being done? Some want our copper, and some want our DNA, water, and air. So what do? We need allies, especially allies with an interest in the Earth. And the Saurians rank pretty high. Making allies is one of the things that we can do, but maybe we don't have to do anything because some humans have already done it. They gave up the copper, the water, the air, and hundreds of thousands of us in exchange for technology to build powerful weapons, which might have been used on the World Trade Center buildings because they came down a little too easily, and some of us don't think that jet fuel melts jet engines, and it isn't possible that it melted construction steel embedded in concrete either. If we have a government that kills our people and makes trades of technology for human beings, I don't think we should trust them anymore, do you? We know that some of those humans were eaten by carnivorous aliens at Dulce. Thomas Costello brought us this very important information. They have a taste for children, and they like to make them very afraid before they tear them apart because they want adrenaline in the blood. It's like an aphrodisiac. I have the feeling that Lacerda's people eat humans too. She hinted at it, and after 65 million years, I think they could have developed a taste for humans. I would take her advice and not stray into her camps. If someone delivered a free pizza to your door, would you eat? I don't want to be anybody's pepperoni, do you? The history of Mesoamerica includes the Aztecas, the Mayan, and the Incas. And they practiced human sacrifice for the gods. And if you look at the gods, they're reptiles. Were these reptiles from Earth or somewhere else? Were they eating humans as meat? We know that the Mayans built pyramids, and we know they were cannibals before we arrived. We brought them Jesus and made them stop eating one another, but we killed 25 million of them in the process. So how much good did we do the indigenous people of Mesoamerica? I'm curious now who the serpent people were who influenced the Mayans and gave them their skills in astronomy and mathematics. They know a lot, and they don't vary much from us, not enough to have done this on their own. Someone had to help them, I surmise. I will have to go back and reread everything I have read on the Mayans, Incas, and the Azteca. The gods that they worshipped were reptiles from Earth, maybe. Lacerda said that they have this special ability to make you think you see a human being, and so you're not afraid. They can get very close to you and then attack. It might be like being eaten by a large snake, and I don't want to be eaten by any reptile. We know that snakes eat mice, rabbits, and deer, so they already have a taste for mammals, and this makes me very suspicious of them in respect to cuisine. Also, I saw some reptiles chase a Russian soldier down and pull his arms off and eat him. Those creatures looked a lot like Lacerda. They drank his blood like savages, and they ate his flesh. Look up these two words on Google, Russian and zombies. It's shot with night vision goggles, and you can see the heat of the poor guy's blood as they yank his arms and legs off, too. One guy in the helicopter vomits in fear. That's real enough to me. The Russian soldier lost his life, and he had a machine gun. I don't have any guns, so what chance do I have? I want to sue for peace. The Pleiadians told us that there are 1.5 million ships around the Earth now, and that they are here to help us with our ascension to fourth and fifth density. We know that recently some of the underground alien bases were destroyed. I wonder if Lacerda's group was affected by this, and I hope their homes were not destroyed. Not because they eat us, but because they are more advanced, and we need a big brother right now. If the Galactic Federation is the Elohim, and they have returned to finish the war with the Terransarians, then I side with the Terrans, and I do not want to be part of any group that invades a planet 65 light-years away and starts turning monkeys into intelligent creatures which make nuclear weapons and claim the Earth as their own when there is a species here to consider. The species of reptiles which have 65 million years of gradual development in order to become sapiens should be respected, not opposed. We should ally with them for our own survival, because I don't see us surviving if the Elohim just extincts their genetic experiment when they're tired of playing in the lab. If the Saurians were belligerent, they could have destroyed us over the past 8,500 years at any time. When the Elohim left, they could have wiped us out, but they didn't. They hide from us and do not seem to want trouble, even though they resent our existence. And I feel more comfortable with them, even if we're on their menu, rather than the genetic manipulators who trash the previous experiments when they are done with them, as if the life forms were no more valuable than lab rats. One last thing. I looked up the Aldebaran, which means in Arabic, the follower, and found Aldebaran right next to the Orion constellation. It's in the Taurus constellation right next to Orion. And I want to show you a map of it so you know where it is. The star is 65 light-years away from us, and the star is a giant like Betelgeuse and Rigel in the Orion constellation. Learning the sky is important now because that's going to be our new home. We are going to travel the stars from here on out, but only if we survive. One of the things that's vital to our survival is to be part of a large organization, a federation, which has some rules that protect us and protect our sovereignty. Invaders will face the entire Federation and not just us. We'd be a pushover to someone who has advanced technology. We need allies with advanced technology also, and we need to get on the rapid track of development, and I see advanced species as the right path. How about you? Next, we don't need leaders who sell out their own kind, and these leaders must be replaced with some that care about the lab rats, the Constitution, and our rights. The slavery and controls have to go. Your paycheck is yours, not the IRS. and we no longer need the Federal Reserve robbing us through inflation and fractional reserve banking, which keeps all of us in debt. So the struggle to be free rests on our ability to elect a constitutional president, and we are denied our candidate, and we have these other candidates pushed on us like the health care control bill, and I don't like that one bit. How about you? We started out talking about reptiles and humanoids from stars 65 light years away, and now we're talking about American politics. Are they related? They are related if we are being led down a path by outsiders. We, the people of the United States, must have our freedoms back, free choice, and not be subjects of a slavery system. And I suspect that the influence comes from outside. And I'm not talking about a Federal Reserve which is owned mostly by foreigners either, or an IRS that's a private corporation and serves as the collection agency for the Federal Reserve. I mean outsiders from other star systems who came to Earth for their own selfish interests and don't give a rat's lab about us. The Lacerda story is important because it's information about who we are and it gives us a direction. We know now what we must do. We must have disclosure of all information about aliens so we know what we're up against. If there's going to be a war, we need to know the truth finally. The truth is never going to come from a government which reports an unemployment rate at 8.3% when actually it's at least three times that number. We're being lied to and we need to see some arrests and we need to see some people in prison. If you think that the Lacerda story is isolated and not relevant to our current situation, remember this. She contacted the Swede who lived in the remote forest because she was concerned about the upcoming war with hostile aliens. More than a decade has passed, and she said it would take place in 10 or 20 years, probably. Do you feel that a war is imminent today? I do. These clowns who are running for puppet president are all talking about war except the constitutional candidate. And they have us believing that Americans prefer war to peace, slavery to the Constitution, and that we prefer the TSA Gestapo to not being touched in our private places before we board a commercial airliner. I'm sure that Americans want to be free. So why do they favor the candidate of the slave masters? Is it mind control? Think about it, and thanks for watching.
While I'd rather do it by myself, stack money, make music, put my product on the shelf. So many haters, man, it's hard to believe.